right, everybody, good morning. I just got out this morning. We got great weather. It's, you know, summertime now. And guess what? Birds are showing up now, and that means speckled trout also. We're gonna get over here. We're gonna see what's happening. There are shrimp literally jumping everywhere you see a bird going down. It's gonna be really fun. Let's throw in there and see what happens. Hope I don't catch me a bird. Oh, there he is already. Oh, got one already. Oh, Lord. Here he comes, there's shrimp just boiling out of the water everywhere right here. Look at this, nice little speckled trout. Oh, he got off. That's okay, look, there's shrimp just jumping everywhere like popcorn right here. All right, y'all. I mean, I literally, when you're in birds, watch this. I could throw right there, pop that cork really good so the fish know that it's there, and then boom, you'll go right under. Oop, there he was, oh, you missed it. There he goes, oh, you missed it. There he is. This is so much fun. Nice speckled trout right there. Oh, Lord. You know, I got to bring some of these home. My mama will kill me if I don't bring her some. Throw them in the well. All right. Let's get them right here. Now, this is some really fast action. And as you see me popping my cork, you'll see, look, it goes right down, right when I'm throwing it. Look, hitting the cork. These fish just get super aggressive underneath these birds, and you just never know what you're gonna catch. That's a small one. I'm gonna hurry up and get him in so he doesn't die. Let's get back out there. This is summertime fishing at its finest, y'all. Shrimp jumping everywhere, birds everywhere, there's fish everywhere. It's just so much fun, and oh, this is what you look for. Oh, there he goes. Come on, get it. Oh, they just can't pass up these baits because it looks just like a shrimp, and a shrimp are jumping. Now, what you wanna do, y'all, when you come up on these birds is always remember, as I did, you come up behind, ooh, there's a good one. Oh, this might be a gaff top catfish. But you come up behind the school real slowly with your trolling motor and don't spook them because there's shrimp jumping everywhere. Gaff top catfish. Catch everything under the birds, it's so fun. Oh man, the excitement. I mean, we just pulled up, and I mean, you think about it, I've already caught, I've literally almost caught probably 5-7 fish already. And I mean, we haven't even really got set up. Oh, come on, get old catfish flippers. And I'll show you how to use these. I'll show you how to use this, and we'll have a link for you to buy this. Cheapest thing that'll save you, I promise you. Let's go to the other side of the boat, they're over here. Okay. Now what you want to do is always remember when you come up on the birds, where the birds are diving is where the fish are. They're in a big boil like this, just schooling around these shrimp. If you throw outside of those birds, you're not going to catch anything. You got to be right in where the birds are diving. Oh, that was a nice fish right there. Look, there's fish, shrimp jumping, fish jumping. Woo! Look at that Versamax cork going under. Look at that, right here by the boat. Look, watch, you could probably see him come up and hit it. That little voodoo shrimp is right there. Let's see. Bring it up. Look, boom, right there. It's that easy. I mean, it's just there, just like, it's like fishing in a barrel is what it is. And they're right here. You just gotta make that little bit of noise, but that just shows you how quick these fish are. Look, boom. Oh, he just hit me right there. See if he comes up again. Nope, let's throw out there. All right, there goes a bird. We gotta throw right in where the bird just hit. Watch, boom. Oh, look at the fish is on it. Oh, he missed it. He had it for a second. He's still on it, there he goes. Oh man, and I'll tell you, you see in that, look, 12 and a half inch trout right here. These fish are by the thousands down there, y'all. There are thousands of them. This is a nice speckled trout. You can see all the specks on them. Beautiful fish, birds diving, shrimp jumping. This is what summertime fishing is all about. And if this doesn't get you excited, then you need to move over to another YouTube channel, because this is not the one for you, I promise you. It's crazy. Look at the birds diving right here in front of us, and the fish are there with them. Now, I'm gonna show y'all, okay, another one. Now, these are some smaller fish that I'm catching right here, okay? Sometimes you can increase your catch by doing a couple of things. You could throw out like a topwater lure, which will get you some more aggressive bites by bigger fish. But if you get a gaff top catfish on that, it's not fun. But you can also just throw out without a cork and do it. But I always find that I just get more aggressive strikes. I get more fish that eat like this one because they hear the noise of these corks. And we'll talk about that also. And we'll make sure we get you a link to this cork because this cork is phenomenal. Look at that. Voodoo shrimp and speckled trout. All right. Let me check him real quick. Got him on. Let's see what it is. Many times, y'all, in the summertime, I think this might be a gaff top, which it is. It's a catfish. There's a lot of them mixed in here with these trout, probably. But when you get out here, I don't know. Let's see what that is. I think it's just a big old gaff top. Oh, Lord. But what happens is the shrimp are getting chased up. This is a great thing. Today, we're just going out. We're going fishing. We're going to have a good time, catch whatever we can. And one of the things is that early in the morning, these birds are going to be diving because these trout and gaff top. Yeah, it's a big old gaff top. That what they do is they get on these birds because the shrimp are getting chased up to the surface, just like they're doing right here inside of the boat. And these big old fish get on it. This is a monster catfish right here. Big old gaff top. And these big ones like this, if you can get it, you gotta watch out. They're poisonous also, but you can lip them like a bass. And they are slimy, slimy. But this is a gaff top. Some people eat them. You can eat them. I don't do it particularly, but it's a really good fighting fish. Really fun with the kids. Let him get in there. I'm gonna try to get out there and get some more. They're right off the back. Look at them. I'm sorry, Caleb, I'm swinging around. I need, hold on. They're so slimy, I gotta wipe my hands. But look, 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 right here, watch. They're gonna have shrimp jumping. Right on the back of the boat right here. Now I can show y'all, I got my anchor set right now. I know I'm backlit with the light and everything, but what happened was these birds, they're just diving right behind my boat. And I have my anchor set for my trolling motor. So the birds and the fish have just gotten right behind my boat right here. So there he is, let's see. Oh, come off. And all I'm doing is I'm using a voodoo shrimp. I really find that these voodoo shrimp work really good under the birds because what happens is, they're real tough, they hold up, and they look just like a shrimp. So why wouldn't you use it? I should have thrown right where that bird was diving right there. Let's see. Come on. Whenever I see the birds diving, I always want to throw right in them over there. That's what I want to do. Oh. All right, let's see. All right, there's one right there. He just dove. Let's catch that fish right there. Oh, there he goes. And the trout are really fast. Shrimp jumping right next to my cork. Come on, fish. Now, water's really dirty here today. So these trout, they're kind of hard to see the bait. Nice little 12-incher right here. Good little fish. Really fun. And these trout will just get on that. Easy catching, really fast, lots of action, and a great thing to do to bring the kids out. Now, what's going to happen is these fish are going to start moving. They're going one way or the other. So what we got to do is we just got to try to follow them. And the way you do that is you watch those birds. They'll be diving. The shrimp will be moving. And you just keep catching them. All right, he's in the... Oh, he got off. I think that was old gaff top. I'm going to tighten up my drag a little bit. Let's see, right here. Oh, there he is right next to the boat. Another trout. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Another pretty trout right there. And all of the trout normally under the birds are going to be a little bit smaller, okay? And with them being smaller like that, you have to remember that those fish, you got a lot of throwbacks in it. So you're going to have to measure a lot of fish as you're catching. And if you've got two or three people in the boat, you're really working. When I'm doing my charters and I'm out here and I got four people in the boat and these fish are flying in, let me tell you, it's pretty tough and it's a lot of work. But that's another about, I don't know, maybe about 12 and a half inch trout right there. Really good. Now my birds have left, but what I'm doing is I'm actually visually looking for the fish hitting the surface and I'm looking for shrimp jumping across the surface. And that's the way you can stay with the school. There he is. Another one. Oh, I think that's a gaff top right there. Yep. Because what the difference is, a speckled trout will come straight up to the surface. And you know that. Whereas a gaff top or any catfish will dig down towards the bottom because that's where they like to live. But the thing is that a gaff top catfish is unlike a hardhead. It's a predator. These fish will come up and hit topwater lures. They'll come up and hit the, you know, baits like I have here. Now, I'm going to show y'all real quick while we're doing this. Let me get my little tool out here. We got a catfish flipper right here. This will keep you, this little gadget right here will keep you from getting stuck by the catfish, okay? So what we're gonna do is, you take this little hook right here on this bait, on this this catfish, it's called a flipper. You take it, and you have a catfish on, and you can do it with speckled trout too if you're catching them really good, or any fish really. But you take, and you get that, the curve of the hook in the curve of that flipper, and then all you do is you hold it tight, you pull against each other and flip them right off. Very easy, awesome tool, and that keeps you from getting stuck by the catfish, because nobody likes that. That hurts really bad. All right, let me reset. I'm gonna get on these birds again, and then let's see if we can get some more trout. Darn gaff top. The old nasty gaff top. And then, as you can see, the slime up above the bait. That's how slimy these fish are. They're nasty, gross. But you gotta wipe it off of there. I don't ever leave the slime on there. I don't know if it's old wives' tale or not, but they say when that's on there, it attracts the other gaff top also. Okay. Oop, I just saw a fish jump. Oh. Right up here, we can see the birds diving. And a lot of times, y'all, when it's smooth like this, see, I can see the actual fish hitting the surface and the shrimp jumping. So that lets me stay with that school. Now the birds are kind of getting active on it because they're starting up again. But we're gonna get right up there, and that's how you do it. You see, I'm coming up behind them. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna get on these birds, but we don't wanna drift through them because we're gonna spook the school of fish. What we wanna do is we just wanna be right up on side of them where we can throw perpendicular and stay on the school the entire time instead of just going through one time and it being over, you know? All right, but as I can tell, just with my trolling motor, as I'm working with these fish, today, these fish, what they're doing is they're swimming because there's not a lot of, we don't have a lot of tide today. So they have to move a lot to catch, to get the shrimp to move. So what they're doing is they're moving a lot. So I have to kind of stay on them with my trolling motor as I'm fishing. And it makes it a little tough, but you know, it's good. Oh, there he is. Gotta get that trolling motor right. Oh, let's see. Another smallie, it's all right. Get him off of there and get back out. This is a numbers game, y'all. As many times as you can throw out, you want to catch a fish, and that's how your numbers, you eventually, you might have to catch 100 fish to get 30 keepers or 25 keepers, but there's nothing more fun than that. Oh, there he is. Oh, he missed me. He's under, but I got to mix with my trolling motor real quick. Okay, here we go. And a lot of times when you're missing a lot of fish, that's just because there are a lot of smaller ones, you know? And you gotta really weed through them. Unfortunately, today, under these birds, there's a lot of gaff top mixed in, and you just gotta deal with them. Oh, he come off. Thank you, thank you. All right, I'm gonna throw way over there where those birds are diving, because that's probably where the speckled trout mainly are. There we go. Yep, I see those shrimp jumping. But see, like right now, I'm kind of outside of the birds and I'm popping a cork and I'm not getting the aggressive strikes like I was before because I'm a little bit outside. So sometimes it's a little bit better to race up to them with your trolling motor to get right on side of them because right where they're diving is where the school is. But they're moving really fast today. And this usually happens about the first hour to hour and a half of the sun coming up. Once the sun gets up a little bit, this usually dies off. So you want to get out here early to get on these type of fish. Now, a lot of people would ask me, you know, why are the fish here? Is there something here? All it is, this is just open water, and these are schools of shrimp that are moving in and out as they do all summer long with the tide. These shrimp are out here feeding, and as they're feeding, they're going with the water that has the best food for them. The speckled trout, they're just there, and they're doing that. And what's happening is they have a symbiotic relationship with these birds. The birds are driving the shrimp down, the fish are driving the shrimp up, and the shrimp just have nowhere to go but get eaten. But that's how it works. Nature does this for these fish and these birds. Oh, the trout missed it. Right there. All right, I'm gonna set my anchor. This is a little bit smaller one. It's a speckled trout. Yeah, a little speckled trout here. And you're gonna catch these small ones in there. But the main emphasis that I wanna show you is, and explain to you, is you gotta have the right equipment. You can come out here and throw pretty much any bait out here and they'll eat it underneath the cork. Sometimes you can tight line them, but the problem is that these fish are aggressively feeding and they're listening for the popping on the surface of other fish feeding on the shrimp or the birds diving into the water. That's how they actually can tell where these shrimp, the little school of shrimp is going. So what you need to do is you gotta have a good cork. This right here is the VersaMax. This is the new Knocker and Pro Series. You can hear it, it's super loud in the water. It's got a cup face on it, titanium wire. This cork really makes a lot of splash and a lot of noise when you're speckled trout fishing especially. When red fishing, I like to use the hybrid a lot, but when I'm fishing for speckled trout, especially under the birds, I like this cork a lot. It just makes so much noise and it really does mimic what's happening on the surface, which is attracting the fish. And if I can mimic that, then it makes it seem natural and these fish get on it. So this rig right here in about, I don't know, about 2.5 feet deep is where I am on it. And always remember with these VersaMax corks, you can go up or down on your depth by just having releasing your wraps on it. That's why it's called a VersaMax. It's got that patented catch right there that works unbelievable. I could change from 2 feet to 1 foot and back to 3 feet in a matter of seconds. So, all right, let's see if we can catch another one. Oh, he got off. Oh, there, he hit me on the pop. Son of a gun, let's see. Right here by the boat. It seems like they're right here. All right, let's throw it back right there. They've got some shrimp jumping right here. I'm gonna throw right there and I'm gonna see if I can get another one. But it's an aggressive pop you have to do. It's not just like a light pop that you wanna, you know, do. You wanna really aggressively pop it. Now, I'm missing a bunch while I'm doing this, so that's letting me know that this school that I just moved up on is probably smaller fish. Oh, he pulled it out of my hand. But the thing is that those smaller fish will have mixed in, have some nice fish. Let's see. Yeah, it's a smaller one, which is very common. Now, when you're out here doing this, you know, you will catch a lot of them. So you have to make sure that you measure these fish. Remember, in Louisiana, it's 12 inches with a pinched tail, closed mouth. If the mouth is open, sometimes it makes them a little bit longer, and that's an illegal fish if he's right on 12. I always go by, if he's 12 and a quarter, he's a keeper. That's what I do, because they'll shrink a little bit also in the ice. So you do that, keep yourself legal, because I can promise you, under these birds, the excitement happens, you start catching them like crazy, and the next thing you know, you got a bunch of illegal fish on the boat, and you just don't want to do that. Let those fish get up, grow up, and be where they're supposed to be. Let's see. Another little trout. Now this is a white trout. Now there's a difference between speckled trout and white trout. This one right here is a white trout. If you notice, he looks just like a speckled trout, except the difference is he has no spots on him. You see that? He's completely free of any spots. These have no size limit or the amount you can keep. I normally, because it's kind of hard to clean them once they get under 10 inches, 10 inches and up would do perfectly fine. And this is about a 10 inch trout right here. And but you got to remember, those fish are a little bit more mushy. So if you're going to go home and cook fish that night after you fish, use those as the ones to eat that first night and then freeze your speckled trout. Just a little word. That's a little tip that a lot of people, you know, because the meat's just a little bit mushy. But you can fill ice chests up with those. All right, there he is. Well, hey, y'all. Look, shrimp jumping right here in front of me. I'm going to tell y'all, this is the most exciting fishing that you can do in the summertime, and it happens during the fall and spring, too. But, man, what an awesome morning. And I'm going to tell you, I've caught so many fish. I'm sweating. I'm having so much fun. I need to get me something to drink. And, oh, man, I'm going to eat good tonight. Beautiful speckled trout.